the two freshmen, Sam Alamuto from Canada and Evan Guillory from New Hampton Prep by way of Missouri, are probably the two most physically gifted athletic guard or players probably that we've ever brought into our program. Huge, huge upside with both of these guys. They're hardworking, they're gifted, they're talented. And I think, you know, we have a lot of experience on the team. So it'll be interesting to see as we move through the summer and into the fall how they progress. But I expect both of them to be pushing to be into the rotation, and both have, you know, are going to be kind of cornerstones of the future of our program. And so I'm really excited about both of those guys.
Coach, I'm curious. I saw Murphy put something out on Twitter. Got to ask you about name, image, and likeness. If this was a long time coming, and, you know, a great coach like yourself entering the 11th year, I'm sure has an interesting perspective on it. A lot of it is fun. You know, there's some things that are local, maybe things like that. I think back to the old Hoosiers movie where, you know, a free win, you get a Saturday trim at the barber. You know, how has that impacted your program with your kids, and how is that sort of a new thing here for Division I programs?
Yeah, I mean, it really hasn't impacted us right now. I think everyone, at least I'm just trying to figure out what the opportunities are going to be realistically. Obviously, we have a community that's very interested in our program. You know, we sell out every game, and it's a big community event. So I'm hoping that there's opportunities for our players. I think it's great that they can take advantage of their celebrity, you know, locally, nationally, maybe, probably not for our guys. But yeah, I'm all for all of this. You know, I think we'll have to see how it goes and what the real opportunities are. I hope there are opportunities. And then I just think the players are going to have to, you know, it's going to be about followers and all that type of stuff, and make sure that they don't lose focus on school and don't lose focus on the basketball piece, you know, worrying about trying to attract more followers and stuff like that. But I don't sense that from our guys yet, but I hope there's opportunities there, and I hope they can, you know, they can make some money.
Every year Vermont, I mean, has just done an amazing job. 16-0 undefeated back in 2016, 2017 in conference, 15-1, 14-2, 14-2, 10-4 last year with the craziness of COVID. What do you say to your team? What's your focus? I mean, obviously to compete for an America East title, but there are just opportunities here. And Vermont is a team that comes on strong. No one wants to see in the tournament. No one wants to play. Non-conference schedule, how have you set that up? What are you looking at for the upcoming year with non-conference and your projections?
Yeah, I mean, again, a challenging non-conference schedule, which I certainly think we, you know, missed out on last year. You know, it really toughens us up, really exposes us. We face a lot of adversity with the teams we play, the environments we play in. But, you know, we're going to play down a tournament in Fort Myers with a bunch of good mid-majors. We open up with Oakland there, and then it's a tournament style, so we'll see what we play from there. We're going to play at Maryland, at Providence, Northeastern, Colgate, Yale, Dartmouth, Brown, you know, and we have to go down to Greensboro to return a game down there, UNC Greensboro. So we'll play really good, the best mid majors out there and some high majors. And, you know, we'll really see what we got. And you know, we'll, like I said, we'll toughen up through that schedule and be ready for conference play. But, you know, my messaging to the team is, you know, we did not win it last year. We lost in the semifinals, and we've got to get better individually. We've got to get better, you know, as a team. And we have a lot of work to do to kind of finish it off this year. And we should be really motivated. We did not reach our ultimate goal, which was the NCAA tournament. We had an opportunity at home in the playoffs that we just weren't good enough. And so the guys understand that. They've been working really hard. And I think there is right now a pretty good focus and energy and edge to us to get better and to get back to the NCAA tournament.